I received this question the other day, and it's I had this question on, I have a video that you highlight the invoices that are over 60 days. They haven't been paid in 60 days, so you know which ones to deal with. In this one, this gentleman says, "Is hi Barb, how can I also sum if in the above example? I have to add all the balances older than 30 days example. In your example, it says you have original balances and disbursements on column B. How can you add such balances after 1 month?" So what I did, I'll show you my finished product here, I did balances over 30 days and balances over 60 days, and then I totaled them. And so I'll just show you how I did it. So basically, how I start this whole premise is up in here, is I put today, which is equals today, opening bracket, closing bracket, and it will give you today's date. But tomorrow when you open it up, it'll say tomorrow's date. So then whether these invoices are over 30 days, it'll be accurate to the day that you're doing it on. So what I'm going to do is, first of all, I'll calculate 30. So we'll go equals, and I'm going to do an if statement. And I'm going to go if this date plus 30, if it's less than this date, then what you're going to do is you are going to display this value here. And if not, another comma, we're going to display nothing. It's going to be blank. And so then I'm going to close that. And you're going to get 250. And what we're going to do when we look at this, so we can drag it down, is we're going to click on the I1 here, and we're going to press an F4 so we can absolutely reference it. Now press enter. And then what we're going to do is we're going to double click on the fill handle to fill it all the way down. And why don't I put those into currency here? Okay, so let's do this again. Let's go equals, and let's do it for 60 days. So we'll go equals, and we'll go if we select this value, and we go plus, and we go 60, and if it's less than, if it's less than today's date, and let's F4 that last one so that it's absolutely referenced, then we are going to display the value, or else we are going to display a blank. So we'll just put double quotation marks here, and we're going to close the bracket, and we're going to press enter. And then once again, we're going to double click down this value and change it to currency. Now to get the totals, what we're going to do is we're going to go to the bottom here, and we're going to hit the automatic sum button. Now it doesn't know what to add, so I'm going to suggest that these ones are the one we want to add. Press enter, and what we can do is we can just click on this and drag it across to get the total for the 60 days as well. So let's double click to get it so we can read it. And so now what we're going to do is up here in the equals our total over 30 days is we'll go and get the total from the total row here. And then, of course, we can drag that across so it gets the total from the 60 row, over 60 days row, or column. So let's double click that to make it there. And so that's how you calculate the total value owed to you that's over 30 days and over 60 days. Please subscribe.